guys, so I want to do like a 5-10 minute workout for you. How to get a dancer's body without any weight, just by using resistance training. So let's get to it. So just gonna stand hip width, shoulder width apart, and bring your hands. Okay, first let's breathe in, right? Let's breathe in. Woo! Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go down, up. You're gonna do 10 reps. What you're gonna do is you're gonna squeeze your palms, and you're gonna feel this in your shoulders, your arms. Okay? Body workout right here. Squeeze palms together. See? Squeeze. Resistance. Yes. Gauge your core, glutes, okay? And you're gonna, okay, we're gonna work the inner thigh. So you need to grab a chair, Engage your core for balance and support. Woo! So do 8 to 10 reps here. Oh, 5, 6, 7, other side. That's right, squeeze. Engage your core for balance. Strength and stability right here, and balance. Woo! Balance. That's right. Okay. Place. Okay, now we're gonna go to do the squeeze. Okay, back. Squeeze. Let's do 10 reps. 2, 3. Engage your core. Right? Squeeze the glutes. Again, if you need a chair for any of this, grab a chair. Engage your core. Put your weight on your left leg for support. And breathe. And squeeze those glutes. Okay, I'm losing track of count here because I'm talking. Now switch. Left, let's see, left leg, right leg, standing on. Engage core. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Squeeze. With, gotta do the, work the glutes. You want tight front glutes on top of the, we just did that, kick back. But also, you wanna, metabolize your metabolism. You want to turn your body to a fat burning machine. You need to work your muscles. So the biggest muscle group we have is our quads, right? So let's do some sumo squats. Feet out. You want your knees to be aligned with your knees. So you're going to squat. You can have your hands here or come out here. Either way, whatever works for you. Squeeze at the top. Okay, squeeze. Squeeze 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If you want, you can hold it here. Feel the burn in your quads. Hold that. Put your weight in your heels. Woo! Feel that burn. If you're not feeling any burn, you're not transforming your body. So it has, you have to push yourself. Woo, breathe. Greater than the songs we sing. Woo, feel the burn. In our weakness and temptation. Woo, shake it out. Okay, let's in. Okay, so that was your quick workout. That was a dancer's body workout. So sorry for the interruptions. My camera kept going out. The song was a little slower, but it is what it is. I hope you enjoyed dancer body workout, resistance training, a workout without weights. So there's no excuse, say I don't have weights to work out my muscles, my body, tone my body. And if you want more of a slim look, then resistance training is great because it'll give you a nice tone look without being all bulky. But if you want to be more bulk, then add the weights. Start with, you know, 5 pounds, work your way up. And if anything though, weight training, strength training, resistance training is key, along with cardio. I'm not sure I'm feeling my heart rate up. I felt the burn in my shoulders and my biceps and triceps. That was a good one right here, right? Squeeze. The key is squeezing into each other for that resistance, right? Squeeze, right? And up here for tricep, right? Squeeze. And you can feel it without weights. You can feel it. And of course the circles here, you're feeling your weight, your body weight, you're keeping your arms up, so you're feeling it. And then a little core workout, you're bending elbow to knee, right? And then we worked our inner outer thighs here, and then our glutes, kickbacks, and then we did our sumo squats, right? So really easy, you could do it a little longer. I'm just doing this a quick tutorial for you, so you can have. I'm gonna be uploading this to my IGTV, so It should be there for you, or YouTube. So whatever it is, wherever it is, you could do this, do it along. And yeah, have a great workout. And you're going to feel great. Get your heart rate up. You're going to kickstart your metabolism, turn your body into a fat burning machine when you're using your muscles. And it's all good. So you guys have yourself a fantastic day. Thank you for tuning in. And make sure to breathe, catch your breath, and out. And yeah, and that's how you're gonna stay nice and toned, healthy, strong, fit, and slim, if that's your goal. You know, there's different goals you have. If you wanna bulk up, be more meatier, then there's other things you need to do. But I'm here to kinda just kinda show you how to have a dancer's body, right? So if that's the kind of look you're looking for, then this workout is for you. And for anybody, honestly, just anything, moving your body is better than doing nothing. So don't find yourself stagnant throughout the day. Get your body moving. Find that thing for you, whether it's dance, it's cardio, it's Pilates, yoga, it's sports, activities outside, bike riding, walking, but you have to be vigorous. And like I said, though, if you want transformation, you want to see definition and tone in your arms and your muscles, you have to do the work of the muscles, whether it's weight training, resistance training, combination, all of it together. And of course, one last thing that I need to add is food. Yes, moving your body, working out is awesome, but like 80% is food. It's what you're putting in your food and how much what you're putting in your food, really, that's the key. Food doesn't get you fat, it's the consumption of food that gets you fat. It's overeating, eating more than your body expends. That's what's gonna keep you not losing weight, that's gonna keep you gaining weight if you're eating more calories than you should. So there's apps where you can look up, where you can plug in your height and your weight, your activity. Is it low, is it medium, is it high? Are you very high active, are you more stagnant? Then, you know, somebody who's sitting in an office all day needs to eat less than somebody who's active all day, right? Can be the same height and weight, but you get two people who are gonna need more calories or less calories based on your activity levels or not. So there's apps for that to keep track of your calories, but really if you're looking to really tone and slim down, feel strong and fit and see definition, well, you gotta lose some of the fat off the muscles because everybody has core. Everybody has muscles here. But if you have layers of fat, you can't see through that. So you need to shed the layers of fat. And the only way to really do that is, of course, move your body, cardio, exercise, weight training. Weight training is probably the big greatest one of all because it's gonna get your muscles activated and it's gonna turn your body into a fat burning machine, which is gonna speed up your metabolism and it's gonna keep burning calories up to 36 plus hours. When you do cardio, when you go for a great walk, it's great. You're exercising your heart. That's what cardio is, cardiovascular. It's getting your heart rate up. It's getting your heart stronger. But once you're done with the walk or the jog or the bike ride, your calories just, you go back to just your regular rate of burning calories throughout the day. But when you do weight training, resistance training, working those muscles, all of your body, that's where your muscles, your body's just gonna keep burning calories after the workout. I mean, isn't that awesome? Don't you wanna do workout? Workout for 20 minutes, a half an hour, work out your muscles, your whole body, and then know that after that workout, your body is still kicking ass, burning calories at a high rate and up to 36 hours. So that's the key, my love, is work, do strength training, weight training, move your body, and be mindful of how much you're eating throughout the day. Okay. Be intuitive. If your body's hungry, then feed it. Like if it's literally like gurgling and growling, because your mind could say, hey, it's time to eat, because our bodies are machines and our body releases ghrelin. It's a chemical hormone that activates to say, hey, it's time to eat breakfast. It's time to eat lunch. So if your body's used to eating like three meals a day and snacks, if you're trying to cut back and start fasting and eat like one less meal or cut the snacks, during the time that you're supposed to eat, your body's gonna register and say, hey, it's time to eat. We're hungry here. But it doesn't mean your body really needs the fuel, okay? I fast, I do intermittent fasting. I can go through a day and eat one meal a day. And of course, sometimes I'll have like a snack, a banana and a granola bite. I have my super green food, has some calories in there that's healthy for me, that's giving me life and nutrients and energy and vitamins and minerals in my body. So, hey. It's okay to fast, but if you never fast, don't just go quit turkey. Like one less meal a day. until you get used to it. It's like anything, like exercising, you got to get used to it. The first day it's going to be like, oh yeah, I could do 2 push-ups, you know, and then maybe by the end of the week you could do 10 push-ups. So it's building up the stamina, the strength, and getting your body used to that activity, right? And food eating is an activity too. Your body works when it eats, right? Your digestive system works. So don't just because I'm telling you this is what I do, right? You know, talk to your medical doctor and stuff. Let them know this is what you want to do. I'm not a doctor at all, and I don't want to give you the wrong advice. This is what I do. It works for me. So what works for me not works for you. Might not work for you. So be clear in that. We are all different. So I can survive one meal a day. That's just me. Okay, so but I was just trying to relate that, you know, people go to the gym and work an hour, be on the treadmill for 2 hours, and they just can't lose weight. It's because you're not pushing yourself more, where you're like, you need to feel a burn in a sense, no pain, no gain. If you're not feeling a burn in your arms and your thighs, your legs, your quads, your hamstrings, whatever, not there's no transformation happening. When you feel that pain, that means your muscles are transforming. So you if you want a different results, you have to work past the pain, feel the burn. When you're feeling a burn, then you know things are happening, transformation is happening in your body. Okay, so there's that, and then of course eating is probably is a big part of life. We're eating all day long, constantly. There's food in our face, there's commercials, it's just temptation everywhere. So you have to be mindful. Again, just go back to what I said, I don't want to repeat myself, but be mindful of what you're eating, how much you're eating. How much you're eating, that's the key, you guys. If you're overeating, your body's gonna store as fat. And after months and years, it just adds on and adds on and adds on and adds on. And it's harder to release it. So you have to eat less. That's what I'm gonna say. Find the happy medium for you. Find, I'm sure, even just one less meal a day. If you eat 3 meals and 2 snacks, cut the snacks out, you'll start seeing losing, you'll start seeing change. So anyways, my love, thank you so much for tuning in. Happy day. And you guys get to work, move your body always, always keep moving, and be mindful to what you're eating and putting in your body. Eat food that loves you back. Don't overeat. And you'll be good. If you need any more, if you want any more information or questions, just reach out to me. You know where to find me here. And I'm here and everywhere, Stacey Ziegler. Just Google me, and I'd love to help you as a coach and work with you if you're a good fit and I'm the right fit for you as a coach. It's all good. But till then, have a beautiful day, my love. I love you. Mwah. Thank you.